So, welcome all to Teledyne Marine webinar series and to today's webinar. I'll just inform you in the beginning that this webinar is being recorded. While I introduce today's speaker, I will start two short poll questions for you to answer, and you will see the poll coming up on your screen. So today's webinar is called Unveiling the Power of PDS, and today's speaker is Alrik van Falkenhoff. Alrik is a senior engineer of Teledyne Research Site in the Netherlands. Alrik joined the company in 1997 as an electronic engineer in the engineering services department. In 2010, he joined the Teledyne PDS support team, and in 2013, he moved to the RD department, as technical writer to supply and maintain manuals and other help and support media. Alrik is a Dutch citizen and he has a bachelor in engineering degree in maritime electronics from the Nautical College of Amsterdam. So you can see this is a very experienced person you are about to hear. During the presentation, you are welcome to ask questions in the question chat. And with these words, I will hand over the presentation to Alrik.
Okay, thank you. So good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. Welcome to this webinar. Welcome to this PDS webinar. Actually, the first one in the series. But since this is the first, I like to keep it simple. I just want to give you an impression what PDS can offer you, and to give you a first feeling how you can use or how others use PDS. So what we will do, or what I like to do during this webinar, first a small introduction, what is PDS? Then I have some slides with examples of applications we support. That takes me approximately 10 minutes. Then I like to start up a real project. And for this webinar, I will start with a multi-beam survey project. But later on, I will also show you a dredge project. In this project, I like to show quickly the control center. I like to quickly show you our acquisition and the concept of our views, layouts, etc. Then I like to show you some offline tools we are supporting. So grid model editor, processing, guidance editor. And then if you have some time left, I like to show you how we are configuring vessels. We have only 30, 40 minutes, so I have to talk fast. what is Teledyne PDS? So multi-purpose platform. So we are supporting multiple applications. So hydrographic, dredge, construction, search and recovery, you name it. So it is a misunderstanding that we only do multi-beam survey or only do dredge. We can do all. And actually all from the same software package. So you just install PDS, and if you have a license to do dredge, then you can just run your dredge. If you have a license for a single beam survey, you just do your single beam survey. It is one package, so you don't have to install all kinds of different applications. So we include a wide range of tasks. So not only online acquisition, but we are also offering a lot of offline tools for your single beam and multi-beam survey, for example. So also a misunderstanding that we only deal with acquisition. We can do both online features and offline features. Then we have interface for a wide range of sensors. So our sensor list is quite large. It's not only related to our Teledyne sensors, it's much more. And furthermore, we can also have different interfaces. So like serial, Ethernet, or also for the dredge, OPC, CAN open, So different support for different interfaces, actually. So then at last, yeah, collect, process, and deliver data in the same workflow. As we are both supporting online tools and offline tools, you can actually do all from PDS. Yeah, so yeah, just unveiling the power of PDS. So to start with the applications we support. So what I mentioned, we do more applications. So just some examples to get an impression. So hydrographic related applications. So yeah, you can always say, of course, multi-beam survey we support. So this is an example of a acquisition screening out to run a multi-beam survey. So we can offer different kind of views, quality control views, plan views, 3D views, but also sonar related views, such as a wedge view here, and sonar view, snippets view, whatever your sonar is supporting. The same applies for a single beam survey, also offering different views to guide your single beam survey, have quality control on it. Such as a helmsman view and 2D plan view with your chart on it, or you can show your depth by means of a line in the time series view, whatever you like. It is flexible. This is just an example. We are supporting multiple views you can add to a certain screen layout. Yeah. Or also, for example, if your single beam outputs echogram data, then you can add an echogram view to your single beam survey. In this example, it is just what you have as echogram type if it is supporting this data, and we have the applicable driver for it. But what I said, so that is online, but also offering the offline tools. So in this example, for single beam survey, we have a volume utility. So you have run your single beam survey, you create a grid model, DTA for it. You have a design model, and then you can compute the volume above the design model and the volume below the design model. Just an example of an offline tool for single beam. But the same applies, of course, for multi-beam. So we have a multi-beam calibration utility to calibrate your roll, pitch, and yaw angles. But also, of course, processing module to clean up your data, multi-beam, single-beam, whatever. Also, with different views you can apply to a screening out, whatever you need to clean up your data or to analyze your data. Later in the multi-beam, I will show you a little bit more about the processing. But it can really also be more sophisticated. So if you have run a multi-beam survey to detect pipes, you can also deal with making a pipe routing with it. So all kinds of features are in the same software package, just the same. So other examples, such as recovery. So, for example, side-scan sonar survey. So then you can show your size or visualize your side-scan sonar data in a plain view, or you can add a side-scan sonar view to your screen layout, and then you have some more possibility to control how it is visualized, color modes, etc. Or you have to have a for search and recovery applications and forward looker sonar. So also support of multiple different sensors with applicable views for that type of sonar. Can also be more sophisticated. So also online and offline tools. So as an example, the gap fill. So to fill your gaps, you have your side-scan sonar data. With multi-beam data, in this example, to show your airplane. Then we are also quite strong in dredge application. So examples of dredge applications are in this screen, a wire crane, but we are also supporting different dredge, excavator, cutter suction, bucket dredge, trailing suction, hopper dredge, you name it. So also supplying the necessary views to monitor the progress of your dredge and what your dredge tool is doing, etc. Yeah, so in this case example, a cutter suction dredge, approach the same for all dredge applications. You can add profile views, you can add plane views, whatever you need to make your dredge efficient as possible. Yeah, or more sophisticated training suction hopper dredge, where we can also monitor production, or where we can calculate and monitor ton drive solid, as example. Yeah, just to realize you that we do much more. Examples of construction is, for example, the pile driving feature. So to drive piles in the ground with the correct in the correct position, in the correct inclination. In this example, measured by your laser scanners to measure the position of the pile. So then you are able to add the necessary views to control or to filter the laser data to detect the piles on a proper way. Yeah, but also the guidance views you need to guide your piles correctly. More sophisticated, we also do monopile placements. The same approach. You can add the views necessary, the quality control views, the guidance views, to place your monopile in the correct inclination and positioning. More sophisticated, cable lay. So even cable lay routing, we have supported for one of our customers. And then at last but not at least, also some port authorities using PDS in this example for routing vessels to the berthing on a safe way, taking into account the depth and the draft of the vessel. Yeah, just examples, just to realize that it's a software package able to run different applications, and it is just your license, your domain license, determines what you can do or what you like to do. But the approach of the views, the layouts, is for all applications actually the same. So then I like to start to show you a project just to get some feeling how that works. So I will close down my PowerPoint. So now you see the Teledyne PDS shortcut on the desktop. So I can start. And what you see now on the screen is our control center. So always when you start PDS, you will come into such a screen, the control center. From the control center, we can start our other utilities and features. And also in the control center, you have the file management of your project. So files can be loaded or deleted or whatever you like from the control center. From the PDS Explorer, actually. You can compare this with the Windows Explorer. So you can drag and drop files into the, in this case, project to have it available. So for example, if I have a grid model received from one of our customers, I can just drag it and drop it. And then it is just placed in the correct node into my PDS Explorer. So now it is here. From the PDS Explorer, I can also start the political editor. So if I have my grid model, my DTM, and I like to edit it, I just can double click on the file to open my editor. And the same applies for sound velocity, or if I have tide or whatever polygon. Every time if I have a file and I double click on it, I can open the applicable editor. So if I open the dike, DTM, then my on the screen this applicable grid model editor in this case opens. So the control center, That is what actually our master application. From here, you can do everything. So also from here, what I said, you can start your other applications, utilities. So I can start from here my real-time acquisition, for example. So then we have here this play button to start acquisition. I click on it. And then my acquisition opens. Yeah, the control center is still active. It is just running a parallel on it. So my acquisition opens with a defined screen layout, as you see now. So the screen layout I defined now by myself is actually what you can make what you like to have. So it is totally flexible. You can add the views you like to have, as many as you like, the location on the screen, the size of it, whatever you like to do, have to run, in this case, your multi-beam survey, you can do. Also, when your vessel is equipped with multiple monitors, you can define for each monitor a unique screen layout. What we say, our presentations. In this example, I just make a screen layout. So what I said, I have many views available I can add to my screen layout. In this example, I added some quality control views. I have an plan view here with showing my survey coverage. I have on the left a 3D model, 3D view, and on the right some sonar control views. So a sonar rich view. And on the most right, a snippets view, and a side scan sonar view below it. And for this type of sonar, I also even have a control possibility to change gain, power, etc. Yeah. So the views actually are accessible from the menu view, of course, and at display. So then I have a dialog from which I can select all kinds of views. Just the one I need, I select. Yeah. So if I like to add, for example, a navigation view additionally to my screen layout, I select navigation, click OK. And in this case, it is placed on top of the survey coverage view. You are also flexible in what kind of information you like to see in a certain view. So now I have added, for example, the navigation view. And then by default, the applicable information is already shown. So like my grid model and my route or whatever I need. But I can add more information to it. And that is done in PDS from the view and layer control. It is the concept is based on layers. So that is why you see the view and layer control buttons in the view. That is this button here. And if I click on it, the view and layer control opens. So I can define additional information into my view. So if I click on this plus sign, I have all kinds of layers available to add that particular information. So suppose I like to see in my navigation view a web map chart, a background chart. I add the webmap layer, webmap service layer. I click OK. Then I can select the type in the properties, what kind of webmap I like to show. So let's say an OpenStreetMap. And then this chart is added to my view. So now I have a webmap as a background chart. Yeah. So I'm also very flexible in what I like to see in my views. Making a screen layout can sometimes time consuming, but PDS offers you also a docking method. So when I make my view floating, so here, then it can be time consuming to drag the borders to make a nice screen layout. But in PDS, you can dock the view. So that is when I right click on my title bar, I have this docking mode. So if I click the dock mode to left, for example, then the view is placed on the left side of my screen layout and filled up the whole space. So then I only have to drag this border to get a nice screen layout, if I like. Yeah, it is placed here because this other view, the 3D view you see on top left, was already blocked to left. But if I can place it on top, then it is placed above this other docked view. So by using docking, so docking to the top, this above three views, or docking to the right, this sonar related views, I can quickly create a screen layout. A nice screen layout without moving views and dragging borders and so on. Yeah. So I'm flexible in the views I like to add to my screen layout. I'm flexible in the information I like to see in the view, and I can actually create quickly a screen layout by using the docking mode. Then, of course, the acquisition, what you see now, also offers the other tools you need, in this case, to run a multi-beam survey. So you have the logging, of course, to log your data. So you can log your data in different formats. Of course, also control about your guidance, so the guidance settings, so to control your run lines, your routes, your waypoints. So all the features needed to run a multi-beam survey in this example are there, are available. Yeah, the whole concept of screen layout views is for all modules the same. What I said, so from the control center, so I've closed now my acquisition, I'm back in my control center, I can also start my other utilities. So for example, the guidance editor. So if I open the guidance editor, this toolbar button, my guidance editor opens, just as an example. So yeah, makes sense, guidance editor, so I can edit my, in this case, run lines or routes or waypoints. So the same concept. So again, view and layer control available. So if I like to show a background chart to make my guidance file creation more easier, I can add the applicable charts, for example, to it, or DXF charts, S57 charts, CMAP charts, whatever. Or also a grid model I can place on the background, whatever you like to do, actually. So the guidance editor offers, besides a numerical way of making it or editing guidance files, in this example, runline files, you can also do it graphically. So if I select my file, I have also grippers on my runlines file, in this example, which I can drag. So I can manipulate also graphically my runline files, in this example. Yeah. Or, of course, I can also create a new one. So edit an existing one or create a new one. So quickly, so new, I can, yes. So I can create a new runline file. So I can say, okay, I like to create a new runline file based on the line, routes, area, whatever I like to have. So let's say I click line, then I can make my line in my guidance editor. I right click, and then the same principle is there. So I can use grippers to do it graphically, or I can do it numerically. Then I also like to show you the grid model editor. So this one. So yes, you can open the editor from by double clicking on the file you have in your PDS Explorer for file management. But I can also open it from the toolbar. So this time I open it here. And then my grid model, my DTM opens. So I can select another one if I have other ones available in my file management. So then I can select certain colors to use. So I can also create color tables, of course, but already prepared. So then I have my DTM, my grid model available. So the grid model editor in PDS offers you all the tools needed to edit your grid model. So you can interpolate, for example, different interpolation methods available. You can update it with new information. You can make contours on it. You have special operations, so you can apply a Z offset, or you can compute a volume if you have another grid model for the same area. So all the tools are there available. Of course, also create new grid model. So I can create new. So I can create a grid model from survey data in PDS, multi-beam survey, single beam survey. Or if you have a customer with an XYZ file, you can also use an import to import certain file formats to create from that a grid model. Also, same principle, view and layer control, you can add background information to it. Then, of course, also necessary for multi-beam survey or single-beam survey is a processing module. So also this from the toolbar from the control center, our master module. I open it and then I have a more nicer view. So I have prepared for this webinar a project with nice data on it. So I open the processing on it. So the processing starts with the so-called file set editor to select the files you like to process. You have logged multiple files, so you can make a selection of it. So I already make this one. And then the files are loaded and I can start my processing. Same concept as in acquisition for the processing. You can add different views to edit your data. So again, from the view at display menu, you have several options to add view to several views available to add. It is just a matter of selecting the one you like to use. So in my example, I just added a positioning editing area standard view, this one, they're on the right lower corner. And I have added a time series view, and I have added a, what you see here on the left, the multi-beam area editing view, which is actually our view to edit multi-beam data. The principle quite easy. If you have a views with data points, like the positioning editing standard view, I can select the data points. If I right click, it gives me several options what I like to do. Delete them, interpolate, move them, whatever. Then this view, the time series view, same principle. You can select data points, you can edit and move or whatever you like to do. But this view is also useful to analyze your data. From the single control, you can add any data you have recorded during your survey. Any device data, any computation, any data source is available. So you can add that to the time series view to show it graphically. And then you have the option to overlay graphs. So in this case, it is already overlaid. So that is actually, if I right click in my view, I can say overlaid. So now the two graphs are on each other. That is easy for comparison, but I can also put them below each other. Yeah. So processing can be used both for editing or for analyzing. The multi-beam area editing view gives also all your tools or different methods to edit your multi-beam data. So you have here on the top left different methods. So you can edit your multi-beam data by means of a cube model. You can edit your data by means of a grid model. Or you can just edit your multi-beam data by means of adding a filter to your data. So from this add filter menu, PDS offers different types of filters you can add to edit, filter your data. Also good to know, when you do processing in the PDS, the real data is not touched. You are only flagging the data. So you can also refer back to original data. Yeah, just to get an impression what we have in our processing module. I like also to show you a Dredge project because we are also very active in Dredge applications. And for this example, just a simple wireframe project. So I start the real-time acquisition again. So starts comes up again with a defined screen layout. So also for this applies the same. You are flexible. You, the customer, defines what you like to use. So adding the views you have, you need to make your dredge efficient. So in this example, I just added a 3D view to show my crane in 3D and the DTM. I have a plan view to show my crane from top with my DTM. And I have here on the left two profile views to show the crane from top, from front, or to show my crane from the left. Yeah, just for the operator, in this case, the wire crane operator, to see what his tool is actually doing. So in this profile view, I have I can also, same concept by the layer control, I can add my DTM, my grid model, and I can add a design model. So the design model, what it should be, the DTM, what it is currently. And then during the dredge, my grid model is updated. Then on the left, I can also add the so-called up-down indicators, also to indicate clearly what is my dredge tool doing. In this case, you are also flexible in what you like to show here. So in this case, I'm showing my dredge, the height of my dredge tool, and I'm showing what the difference is of the height of my dredge tool related to my design model. But you can assign any value which is useful for you to show, to monitor. Then the plan view, the center view, can also show different models. So I can show my DTM, my grid model, representing the current depth of my area. But I can also show, for example, if I have a design model available, the difference between my current depth and the design, the so-called differential model. So that is this. So by means of defining a color table, I can have a clear indication of the progress of my dredge. Am I working within my tolerance, yes or no? Or to visualize better the dredge tolerance model, this one, to show if you are working within defined tolerances, over dredge, under dredge. Yeah. Teledyne Marine is also a supply of delivering their own dredge monitoring system. And that is, of course, fully supported in PDS. So also calibration of tools is available. So you have the tool calibration. So to calibrate, in this case, for a wire crane, my boom angle, or to calibrate the wires on my drill, or to calibrate my height of my tool, depending on the length of my rope. So it also includes calibration, different calibration methods, to calibrate actually my machine. Yeah. The same approach for any dredge application. So excavator, wire crane, cutter suction dredge, training suction hopper, same approach. But of course, we are also interfaced besides the Teledyne dredge monitoring systems with other dredge monitoring systems, the Trimble system or whatever. At last but not least, how do we define our vessels? Also, just briefly. So now I already have a project defined, but my project settings are always accessible. So for instance, my project settings. Oh, wrong button, sorry. My project settings. Yeah, I have the possibility to set my units to select my coordinate system. We have in PDS several predefined coordinate systems available you can select from. So that is all you can all set, you can all change. Same apply for my configuration. So that is this tool button, or for this gear button. So to change my configuration, so the configuration is actually telling me how I do my job. How the application has to function. So part of the configuration is the vessel configuration. So now we see here this. And that is actually the definition of our, in this case, because we have a dredge application, of our machine, our wire crane. So if I open Then I have this page, and here I define our machine. I configure our machine. So I can set the geometry, I can set the device offsets, I can have my equipment added to my machine. And this is exactly the same approach as when you have a multi-beam vessel or a single beam vessel. So you make a configuration of your vessel. So in the equipment page of it, you can add different drivers, you can set your I/O, and much more, guidance, tools, whatever. So in the tool screen configuration, I can define mine, in this case, wire crane, boom, wire crane rope, and I have several options to define my wire crane tools. But if I have an excavator, exactly the same. So that is actually in a rocket flight running through PDS. Get you triggered, and yes, it goes very quickly now, but if you like to know more of a particular subject, then just submit a message to us, and then we can explain in more detail, or even arrange a webinar for that particular subject. So, can I give it back to you?
Yeah, just keep your screen there. Thank you so much, Ulrich. I thought it was very detailed, but I'm not a user. so I guess this is a program that can do an awful lot, as you also said. We had quite a few questions coming in. I'm also aware that we are running over time. So for those of you who have to log off, as I said before, this webinar will be or is being recorded, so you will always go back to our link webinar page, which Ulrich is referring to here on his closing slide. But we will start answering a couple of your questions for those of you who would like to hang on. So Ulrich, I will start with the questions.
Okay.
Question is, does PDS support MBS and TOAD SSS simultaneously?
Multibeam and SSS simultaneously, yes. Yeah.
Okay.
yeah, because you saw in my start screen. Is it meant that so you have a multibeam on your vessel and you are towing a seismic sonar? Is that what is meant? Because if the multi-beam, we have also multi-beam systems which can produce seismic and sonar data and simultaneously multi-beam data.
Okay, thank you for that. The next question that has come in sort of more around our PDS and our sister company / software. Does Teledyne intend to keep PDS post-processing and carries HIPS and SIPS?
I don't know. I can say yes, but let me check this out. But yes. I don't know of any plans to that the processing module of PDS will be removed. No. But let me check for sure. But for now, I can say no. Yeah.
Okay.
But also be aware that we are working together with CARIS, and so PDF files can also read by the CARIS processing module. Mm. Yeah.
Exactly. Okay. Next question is a bit more on the technical side again. Is there a possibility to see the navigation data in digital numbers like data rolls?
Sorry, Helen, the navigation data digital?
It says, is there a possibility to see the navigation data in digital rows? Can I see who? Maybe we can get back to that one in an email.
Yeah, let me come back to that one. Yeah, that is, if you have a mail address, I can find out. Yeah.
Does there exist any way to not change automatically between lines?
Not change automatically between lines. So the run lines is meant, I believe, then. So then you want to select manually the run lines. That is possible.
And it's possible not to change automatically. So you have to do it manually.
Yeah, indeed. But let me give the questioner more details about that. Yeah.
Okay, I'll do that and move on to the next question. When we finish a line, we automatically start recording in the next line file. But sometimes we want to do a larger survey, so it's not useful to automatically start recording, I guess.
Let me also come back to that in more detail. I don't know for this.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
then there's a request to grid model from the beginning. I think you showed that a few times, and there's follow-up question saying we have problems changing the grid model when we do a new survey.
I have to investigate, but they have problems to create the grid model for a new survey.
Let's get back to that one. Maybe it's a support question.
We have to go deeper in that than if we have the address, then we come back to that. No problem. Yeah.
Okay. Great. So is it possible? What does it say? Multi-spectrum data acquisition and processing is possible? That's how it's written.
So to run simultaneously, processing and acquisition. Yes, that is possible.
Okay. I think I'll let this one go in. So the last one I would take here is, can PGS detect the noise data in multibeam?
The noise data in the multibeam detection. Let me come back to that as well.
Okay. And then finally, a request to, do you have any webinar for mobilization for survey and dredges and a webinar for plot and layout? No, but we will have them. Is that something you can set up, Alec?
Yes, of course. Yeah. Glad to do so. Yeah.
So with those words, do you have anything else to add, Alec?
No, not really. It is, yes, indeed. If people like to have more details or have a technical question or a problem, indeed, if they're suffering with PDS, just submit a message and then we definitely will have a look to it. Yeah.
Okay.
And for more information, we can try to arrange sending information or indeed arranging an other webinar for just a specific subject. Yeah.
Okay, then that I would say thank you very much for attending. And Alec, thank you very much for giving this very interesting presentation. So
yeah, you're welcome. Yep.